So welcome to this channel, IBM iCasa. We started this new channel to provide basic insights of IBM i400, RPG, CL and DB2. So today we'll cover the basic concepts of pointer in RPG. So let's start with pointers. We have created one source file for the same IBM classes. So here we have some demo programs already created. First one is PTR demo 1, which is the basic program in this we have created one variable name string and one final string and one variable PTR for name, which is pointer. So this string is based on this pointer variable, so this will hold the address and whatever the value at this address will be holded by this. So we have evaluated this name string as this one, this name. And finally, we have passed the address of this name string to PTR for name, and PTR for and final string is based on this PTR for name. So whatever the address in PTR for name, then based on that address, the value is stored in final string. So here in this case, final string will contain the value in name string because it holds PTR for name contains the address of name string. So we can show you the demo for this one. We'll compile this in qtemp with the star source. Then we'll debug this program. So this is not valid, so we'll end debug first. We'll debug this program, PTR demo 1 in qtemp, set the breakpoint, we'll call this program . You can see currently this contains blank, and after the execution of this line, this will contain a test name. Now we have passed the address of this name string to PTR for name. Currently, PTR for name contains null address. So after the execution of this line, this will contain the address of this name string variable. We can see the value at this address by typing eval, then pointer name in colon C, then that the length of the address. So here we can see that this address contains this value. So since final string is based on PTR for name, so we can see the value here as well, this thing, which is then gets displayed using display keyword. We can see the same in display job log using command DSP job log F10 and Shift F6. So here we can see that this name was displayed. So this was the basic. This is just the basic program for pointer. Now we have created another program, PTR demo 2. So in which we have created a one sub procedure which is exportable. So for this we have used no main here in htux, which tells us that there is no main procedure for this. So we will create the module for this, and then we'll create the service program for this, and we'll use this procedure by binding the same service program PTR demo 2 to the calling program. So here we can see that this is the prototype for the procedure prepare final string, in which we input the pointer and then it returns a pointer. So which is, we have used value keyword here, which means that we are not calling by reference, we are calling by value. And now we have started, we have begun our procedure prepare final string, and we have used export keyword. So we can export this keyword, we can use this procedure anywhere, not only in this module. So we have, this is the PI procedure input for this procedure, which takes input as pointer and returns pointer. We have declared the standalone variable final form string, which is based on this pointer variable. You can see the length of the string is 50 years. So this pointer variable will contain the 50 character length value. Now you can see that we have evaluated the input address to this PTF or final form the string address. So whatever the value in this address will, since this address gets stored into this, so whatever the value in this will be reflected in this. So this string is based on this value. So now this string will contain the value which is present at this address. So we have concatenated blank and appended blank and then timestamp to this input string. So we'll get the final string which contains the input string plus the timestamp as well. Now finally we will return the final formed string address. So this is the end of procedure. We have created one more program called ptldem for which is calling this procedure. So this we have declared PR and PI as main, and we have set XCPGM and this called PTRDEM, since we are replacing this with an entry parameter calling. Now we have declared the prototype of the procedure which we are using, which we are going to call in this program. So for this we have declared one input string of empty length and one final formed string which is based on this pointer. So we have evaluated current timestamp is an input string, and then we have called this prepare final string procedure by passing the address of that input string, because this procedure takes input as a pointer and then returns the pointer ptr, then the pointer in ptr for final formed string. So this pointer, this string is based on this pointer. So whatever the address will return here, the value at this address will be shown. So we'll show you the demo. We'll first create the module for this by using create rpg mod command in qtemp with star source. So the module gets created in qtemp. Now we create the service program. PTR demo 2 in qtemp, module is same, and export as star all. So this program PTR demo 2 created in library qtemp. I'll create the module for this calling program in qtemp with star source. Now we'll create the program. Call ptrdem in qtemp. Set the modules. Then we bind a service program ptrdemo2. So program this gets created in qtemp. We can see what all objects in qtemp. Work object qtemp slash star all. So we can see that we have this ptr demo 2 service program and module. We have this module called ptr dem and called ptr dem as pgm. This was the earlier program ptr demo 1. So now we'll debug this program. Call ptr dem. Set the breakpoint as one. We call qtemp slash call ptr dem. Now see this string is blank. After the execution, this contains some value, that is current timestamp is this. Now this procedure gets executed into this by taking shift F10 and then come into this. So this, we have passed the address of that value name string, input name string. So here we have address. So this address gets evaluated to this one. We can see what value we, whether we have the correct value gets passed or not by using eval, then pointer name, then colon, c, then length, that variable. So yes, we have the correct value. Current timestamp is now this statement will append the blank and timestamp after this find after this input so we'll see final formed string is now current timestamp is then blank then timestamp so we get this final formed string so we'll return the address of this because as per the tuple type it takes input and it returns a pointer both are the same so it returns the pointer so it returns the address with a c whether the value is correct or not colon c then 50 yes we have written the correct appended value current timestamp is 2019 05 26 so on so we can also see the same value here final formed string because this is mainly based on this pointer variable this address as here you can see here and now this program ends it will display the value you can see the same in job log as well okay this one so we have shown you here two programs one is the basic program for the pointer and other one is some complex program not complex we can say that we have used the procedure concepts of procedure concepts and we used pointers in that so we have used the input and return value as a pointer we saw that how the pointers values flow within procedure or outside the procedure so we have created a service program there and then module as module in service program there so we shown you how we can use the pointers in our sub procedures or service programs and then how we can call the sub procedure defined in the service program using the pointer so this is the basic demo for the pointer for this video we'll show you some more examples of the pointers how we can use pointers otherwise in our next video so till the time good luck and bye bye.